In this problem, we want to know if these two planes are parallel, and we have them equations of the plane in vector form. So I have negative 1, 2, 4, dot product this equals 0, and 2, negative 4, negative 8, dot product that. Remember what vector form is. It is going to be vector n dot product vector r minus r0 equals 0. That is going to be the vector form. And if I just look at these two vectors, this vector n1 clearly is, if you look at it, negative 2 times vector n2. Because negative 2 times that is 2, negative 2 times that is negative 4, negative 2 times that is negative 8. So the two vectors to which these planes are perpendicular, meaning their dot product equals 0, the dot product equals 0, so this comes from the two points in the plane, this comes from the vector parallel to that. If this vector is just a scalar value of the other one, then of course they do point in the same direction, they just are different lengths. In other words, they are parallel to each other, meaning that these two don't have to do this dot product, you don't have to do anything, these two are indeed parallel to each other. Now for this problem, which might seem difficult at first glance, we must find an equation of the plane through a point perpendicular to a line, but we are given the line in polar coordinates. And we need to find out what this equation of this plane is. So imagine just the following. Imagine I have my plane there. I have my coordinate system here, and I have my line going there. It's just an imagination. And these two here have got to be perpendicular to each other. That has to be perpendicular. I know a point on the plane, let's call that point P0. I don't know where they intersect. In as much as I only have that form of the equation of the line, I don't know the equation of the plane, impossible for me to find out a thing where they might intersect. What I can do with that is, though, I can form two vectors. I can form two vectors by getting, if I could get two points, let's call them point L1 and L2 on this. In other words, I can form a vector. I can also choose another random spot on this plane, call it P, and I can get another vector. If I have these two vectors and I multiply them, or I do the dot product, never say multiply, and I do the dot product between them. Now, I should have done this perhaps in a slightly better way, in as much as, say, for instance, I chose P there. So P0, P, and L1, L2, if I get their dot product, that should equal 0, irrespective of, you know, where they are in space. Let's have a look at that. Let's get two points on that line. Let's get point L1. How can I do that? Well, I can substitute any value into t, because remember t is any value from negative infinity to positive infinity. Let's say t equals 0. That is going to give me x equals 4, y equals negative 2, and z equals 0. That leaves me with point L1 being 4, comma negative 2, comma 0. Let's get another point here, and it's t equals 1, just making it easy for myself. If that's 1, that means x equals 6, and if that equals 1, that is 3, that leaves me y equals 1, so I'm taking that 2 over to the other side, and that leaves me z equals negative 5. In other words, I have point L2 as 6, 1, negative 5. 6, 1, negative 5. If I now get vector L1, L2, that's going to equal 6 minus 4 is 2, 1 minus negative 2 is 3, negative 5 minus 0 is negative 5, So I now have this vector. What if I get vector p0p? Well, I just have to get a point p as well, and I'll just make that x, y, and z, can be anything, still in that plane. And if I get p0p, dot product, my p0p is going to equal x minus, I do have point p0, there's point p0, x plus 2, y minus 1, and z minus 7. If I get the dot product between these two, I'm going to get 2 times x plus 2 plus 3 times y minus 1 minus 5 times z minus 7, and that's going to equal 0 since these two vectors are parallel, or I should say that one, these two vectors are parallel to each other. In other words, 2x plus 4 plus 3y minus 3 minus 5z plus 35 equals 0. So I'm going to be left with 2x plus 3y minus 5z, and I have 4 minus 3 is 1, 1 plus 35 is plus 36 equals 0, an equation for my plane in standard form. And here are two very interesting questions. The equation of a plane parallel to the xy plane and the equation of the xy plane itself. And you've got to draw this out in your mind, as even the previous problem, if you draw that out in your mind, or you draw a little picture like this, it actually becomes quite clear. So I have my x, y, z coordinate system. The back plane is in the back plane here. It's in the x, y plane, and this one is a bit forward in the x, y plane. So let us take that is the x, y plane parallel to the board, with z coming out at you. Now, let's take 2 points in that parallel plane, the plane parallel to the xy plane. I can take 2 points in it, and I can call one point p0, which is x0, y0, and z0. I can take another point, x, y, 0, and I can construct a vector p0, that's rough, p0p, which is just going to be x minus x0, y minus y0, and z minus z0. Now, that is a vector in this plane. It can point anywhere in 360 degrees there. Anyway, now, I need a vector parallel to that plane. And that is where, looking at this picture, it becomes quite clear. And that vector parallel to this plane of mine has got to go along the z-axis. Anything along the z-axis is parallel to the xy plane. And I can just take the unit vector. Why don't we just take the unit vector along that plane? And that unit vector along z is going to be 0, 0, 1. It's not going to move on the x direction, it's not going to move on the y direction, it's going to come straight at you, straight. And that's z1. Now, if I do these, 0 times that, nothing left, 0 times that, nothing left. So I'm left with z minus z0 equals 0, in as much as the dot product between these two have got to be 0. And there I have an equation for a plane parallel to the xy plane. As simple as that. As simple as that. Now, what about an equation for the xy plane itself? For the xy plane itself. Now, for that to happen, I've got to choose my second point, and my second point has got to be at z equals 0. So my second point here is not going to be x0, y0, z0. But my point on that plane is going to be x0, y0, comma 0. y0, comma 0. Why 0? Because no matter where on this plane, in the xy plane, I choose a point. No matter where I choose that point, it is going to lie on z equals 0, because I'm at the xy I'm at the xy plane. In other words, this becomes z minus 0 here. That becomes z minus 0 here. And now if I multiply them out, I'm going to have 0 times that, 0 times that, 1 times that. So 1 times z minus 0 equals 0. And that leaves me with z equals 0 as an equation for the x, y. Unfortunately, the memory card was full, so I'll have to put these videos together. So we know now that z equals 0 for the xy plane. That means that is for xy. If I make xz plane, that means y equals 0. And x is going to equal 0. X is going to be 0 for the yz plane. Similarly, this is a plane parallel to the xy plane. So y minus y 0 equals 0 is going to be a plane parallel to the xz plane, and x minus x 0 equals 0 is going to be a plane parallel to the yz plane. Important thing to note, the most important thing is for the plane xy plane, my point is going to be x 0, y 0, anything. X can be 3, y can be 10, but z is always going to be 0 on that plane. So I choose a 0 there. I choose the unit vector in the opposite direction, in the perpendicular direction. So this xy plane is going to be along z. If I want along the x, that is going to be 1, 0, 0. And if I want the unit vector along the y, that is going to be 0, 1, 0. And I'll choose which one is perpendicular to my plane. And for the other planes, this will become 0 or this will become 0. On the planes, though, I can have parallel planes, I can have any value. Along this plane, z0 is going to be some specific point, but I don't know what it is, so I leave it z0, and I can multiply, I can get the dot product of the unit vector parallel to that plane, and out jumps my equation.